What's up, everybody? I hope everyone's having a good day. I hope everyone's taking care of themselves. I hope everyone's getting plenty of nutrition, plenty of exercise, all that good stuff, taking care of their bodies. I hope everyone's getting into the studio and getting creative. And overall, I hope everyone is having a good Sunday. We're going to jump right back into it again today, folks. We are getting into learning how to mix with more depth. And today we're working on concentrating on a particular type of reverb, the Waves Audio H reverb. And I have a couple of different delay styles I'm going for with this type of reverb. I'm going for a nice room sound and also a nice 80s snare sound. Let's go ahead and hear some of the song and start getting a decent room sound.
Fine place for a day full of breakdowns. Takes more than a meltdown to show us how. Throw a tack on the road, stop the meat plow. Got a bullet, but it ain't mine. They got these pictures of everything. To make amends, yeah, to make amends with
important, and I'm starting to remember this, is that you want to make sure your subgroups are included in your
Effects groups. So I want to make sure to hear the music and the vox and the drums and the backing vocals. Yeah, I want to make sure to hear and the effects. I want to make sure to hear all of those. So let's include all of those, shall we? There we go. And we have the ability here to also expand these controls, and there's just a ton of different controls that you can have in here. I may mess with some of these, I may not. I'm just going to sort of play around with how the room sounds on this and then start hearing it in context and start kind of getting it dialed in. So. All right, so I'm just dialing this in. I just want to talk a little bit about these controls for anyone who's interested. So the decay envelope is here, right? Input echoes, output echoes. You can turn all these things on and off. You have dynamics controls. You have EQ, reverb, and damping. Envelope and LFO controls if you want to get really deep into modulation and doing that sort of stuff. I'm just trying to get a little bit of room into this song. That's all I'm trying to do. I might mess with this drive control. That's looks a little cool, but let's just kind of keep going here and see what we can come up with here. Maybe a touch of that drive sounds pretty cool. So let's give it a shot. I think that's good. I like it. So we're going to get it back into the mix and just start toying around with how this sounds in context, all the different elements. In my natural fashion, I might throw the faders up. I might close my eyes. I'll just kind of see how I react to it and get it a decent sort of blend going. So here we go. Sounding good so far. So what I'm going to do now is check out my other H-reverb instance that I have set up here, and it is set up for that 80s snare. I'm hoping that it's a pretty simple AMS non-Linn sound. It looks like it is. It's a real short, gated sort of sound, and this is half a second, right? So that's probably exactly what this is. There's a couple of big da-da-da-da-da sort of snare moments that I want to accentuate through this. I just want to push through this reverb a little bit. So we're going to check out how this sounds. It is the same exact reverb, just a totally different sound set up to it. So instead of a room sound, it's an AMS non-Linn sort of a reverb sound. So I've got that set up on this channel, non-Linn, and I'm going to go ahead and output to, I actually need to get my interface bus set up correctly. There we go. So that's plate, room, hall, and non-Linn. There we go. And let's go ahead and get our busing set up here on all of our channels. So we're going to go out to non-Linn. Boom. And then here we go. Let's start hearing what this sounds like. I'll go ahead and grab all of these channels and that, and set up a group for non-Linn. Do we have N in use? Nope. So, winner, winner, chicken dinner. So we got our group set up. Let's start checking out how this reverb sounds.
Understand, yeah, to understand.
See, that's that's what I'm also going for in a way. Not having that on really at all ever, but just for those snare moments. You know, and just for those sort of... So let's hear that a bit in context. So I'm gonna unsolo all this stuff again. So that's the idea for the AMS non-lens sound. When I go through and do some automation and really ride those snare moments, I'm going to ride that non-lens sound. So, yeah, real cool stuff. The Waves H-reverb, right? Capable of so much. And I will say, if you're on version 12, then you also know what the deal is with regard to GUI size. Really, really awesome UI improvements and just ability to customize the size of the screen and the interface to your needs and what you need to see there. Tons of controls, tons of additional options. Just make sure to hit this expand and collapse button here. You can also globally turn off input, output, echoes, dynamics, modulation controls just with those button clicks from the front face of the panel without even expanding. But if you want to dig into the controls too, you can have at it, right? And I would also recommend dig into the presets. Hit the load menu, go to the preset browser, right? Start typing in room. Find tons of options. Start typing in non-Lin, right? Or 80s. That's how I found that 80s snare, right? So, I mean, there's just a ton of ways to make use of this plugin. So check it out. I am definitely checking it out for this song and mixing with depth. So... Until next time. Pictures of